Hello everyone and welcome back. My name is Gergely Németh and I'm one of the founders of RisingStack and also the co-author of the Node Hero blog post series. In the first part of this video series, we taught you how you can debug Node.js applications easily. If you didn't check that out, I recommend watching that first, as this video will make a lot more sense. So in this one, I'm going to show you how you can handle asynchronous operations easily and how you can do performant applications in Node.js using them. So we are going to take a look at error handling with asynchronous operations and how you can use the async module to handle multiple callbacks at the same time. So let's get started. I have a really small project setup. You can see that I just created an empty package.json basically, and I'm using Node.js version 4 for now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you can do async operations easily. So for that, I'm just going to head over to my Atom and let's create a file. For this, I will just call it read file, because what we're going to do is that we are going to read our package.json file asynchronously with all the possible error handling scenarios to show you how you can do async operations easily. So what I'm doing is I'm simply requiring in all the necessary modules that I'm going to use. And actually it's just gonna be fs, and just to make sure it runs smoothly in every file system, I'm going to require the pass module as well. So most of the core modules exposing asynchronous interfaces, so do the fs module as well. So to read a file, what we are going to do is call fs read file, and we are going to give the package.json file as we want to read that. So what I'm doing is I'm saying that as the first parameter of the read file, I'm saying pass the join, and here I'm using a constant, a global variable that's exposed to all npm, all node modules, all files. So basically the dir name will give us back the location of this file where it runs, and because the package.json is in the very same folder, I'm just going to say package.json, and it will know that which package.json file to read. So this is how it looks like. Also, as I'd like to read it using UTF-8, I'm just passing it as an extra argument that I want this encoding. So this is how the signature of this function code looks like, but how you can actually get the result of this. So if we weren't using asynchronous programming, then it would be something like var result equals this one. But in Node.js, this won't fly. Instead, what you can do is that you have to register callback like this one. And what happens in the background is that when you register it, the operation system starts to read the file. And when it's ready, this callback will be called. Notice that the very first parameter is the error. This means that if anything goes wrong, this variable will have value. If not, it will be undefined or null. So the next is the result, which is the actual file that we want to read. So let's see. First, let's handle the error. So if we have an error, then we should definitely do something, and we should not continue the execution of this file. So this is why I'm returning something. And for the sake of simplicity, now I'm just saying console.error error. So basically, with this return console error, we are stopping the execution of this file, of this function, and also we are putting out the error to the standard error. But if it's okay for now, let's just simply console log it, so the result. Let's see what we have done. So I'm just going to run the read file function, and voila, we got back the package.json file that we had. So far, so good. But what would happen if the given read file function fails? So let's just put a little typo in there and see what we get. Yeah, you can see that the error is printed out. It says that there is no such file and directory as the patch, the JSON file. So this is actually the expected behavior here. Okay, so let's just put it back. But actually there is one more thing that we have to handle here, because this result here won't be a JSON object, but it's a string. So actually we have to parse it so it becomes an object. For that, what we can do is say const object equals json.parse result. And now this object will be a JSON object that we can actually grab properties from. So let's see what we have done. Great, so we actually could read the file here and the name of the package JSON. But again, it can have errors here. So let's see what happens if our package JSON is malformed. So I'm just going to remove this comma here, and let's see what happens. Ooh, unexpected string. So actually what happens is that here the JSON parse object, the JSON parse function, will throw an error for us, and we have to catch that. This will be asynchronous error handling. You can notice that this first part was asynchronous because we registered a callback, and here for the JSON parse we have to do it synchronously. So what we can do is use a try catch. So what we are going to do is we are going to move the JSON parse inside of the try. So if anything goes wrong, we will catch an error here. So let's just put the very same thing here. Console.error, error, and actually returned. And it should do the trick. So let's see if our package JSON is still invalid. And now we are going to see if we are outputting the caged error. Yes, we ran into here, but that was undefined. So I just printed out the wrong variable. Now we get the good one, and you can see that we have an error, a syntax error, that was an unexpected string there. And now if we fix our package JSON, putting back the comma, it should work again. Great. Perfect. So just as a reminder, what we have done here. So first of all, we read a file asynchronously. We handled the asynchronous error here. Then with the JSON parse, which could throw an error, we handled the synchronous part here and we just outputted the name of the object. So that's how you can easily manage errors and asynchronous operations in Node.js. But it's far from a complete example. So the next thing I'm going to show you is how you can handle multiple asynchronous operations easily. So for that, we are going to use an npm module called async. So let's just install it. And we have to require it in our application. And with async, you can actually do a lot of great things. So this is the GitHub profile of async. What you can do, see here in the documentation, is a lot of utility functions that help you coordinate asynchronous functions easily. So what I'd like to show you as an example usage of async is reading two files. So now we had one, let's refactor it to read two package JSON files. For that, we will create another JSON file. Let's call it package clone.json. I'm simply going to move stuff from here to there and just going to rename it to append the extra clone to the end of the name. So now we have two JSONs and we'd like to read them all. So if we would want to do it here, we would either copy paste it or just do some nasty things like fsheet file here again, but that's not something that's very maintainable and you'd like to do. So for that, we are going to use the map function of the async utility set. So what we are going to do is in the map, we are going to put the two files that we'd like to read, the package JSON and the package clone.json files. So we'd like to read these two. And the function that we'd like to execute will be put here. So actually we know that this is the name of the file that will be called. Also we have a callback that's supplemented by async. And what we are going to do is move the logic that we've done previously to here. So we will actually read file, use the read file function inside of async. The only thing that we will modify is that this won't be a hard-coded value, but we are going to use the name. Other than that, it will be the same, except now instead of using console errors, we are going to use the given callback. But not just for our errors, but also for giving back the result. And one interesting thing here, one really important thing to grasp here is that error-first callbacks are everywhere in Node.js. So here, if all went great and there was no error, we have to explicitly tell it to the callback that this function successfully ran, so there was no error and async will know it properly. So let's put out the result. Let's see if it works. Node read file. Wow, great. So as you can see, with the map function, we got back the two names, the original one and the one which was cloned, right back to the terminal. So, and also after that, because I forgot to delete, this was the original that ran as well. So let's just remove it. And here you can see that instead of just monkey patching some async functions to work together, we actually using async could easily create parallel running functions with map. So if you'd like to get to know more about how you can do and what you can do with async more, just check out the documentation, which can be found at Colin's GitHub site, and you will be in good hands. Thank you.